In this video, we're going to show that any function can be written as a sum of an even function and an odd function. And at the top, just to remind you real quick, an even function is a function for which f of negative x is equal to f of x, and the graph of an even function would have symmetry about the y-axis. An odd function is a function for which f of negative x is equal to negative f of x, and an odd function would have rotational symmetry about the origin. So now let's consider a function f of x that's not necessarily even or odd. There's a really cool trick for writing down an even function by using f of x. I'm going to call it g of x. And g of x is defined to be f of x plus f of negative x. We can prove really quickly that this is even. We evaluate g of negative x, and that gives us f of negative x plus f of negative negative x, which is f of x. Well, that's exactly the function we started with. It's the sum of f of x and f of negative x. So we just showed that g of negative x is equal to g of x, and therefore g is even. There's an equally cool trick for creating an odd function out of any function f. All I do is put a minus sign in front of that second term. H of x is f of x minus f of negative x. And let's test the parity of h by plugging in negative x for x. And I get f of negative x for my first term, and then minus f of negative negative x, which is f of x. And that's not quite the function we started with. The terms have been reversed in order, but there's a minus sign between them. In order to get a comparison with my original function h, I'm going to factor a negative 1 out, and that gives me a positive f of x and a negative f of negative x. And there's my original function h. So I get negative h of x. Since h of negative x is equal to negative h of x, that shows that h is an odd function. Finally, I notice one more useful fact. If I look at my definitions of g, which was an even function, h, which is an odd function, so I notice that if I add these, I would get 2f of x, and the f of negative x part would eliminate. So g of x plus h of x is twice f of x. And if I divide by 2, I now have an expression for f of x. In terms of an even part, that's 1/2 g of x, and an odd part, 1/2 h of x. So now I'm going to shift my notation, and I'm going to call these capital E and capital O for the even part and the odd part. So the even part of this function is 1/2 times the g of x that I started with. So 1/2 times the quantity f of x plus f of negative x. And the odd part of my function is 1/2 times the quantity f of x minus f of negative x. And you can check real quick that if you add this even and odd part, you get back to the original function f of x. So any function can be decomposed into even and odd parts by using these little formulas. Now things get interesting when we apply this to an example. I'm asked to show that e to the x is not even or odd. And then I'm asked to find the even and odd parts of f of x and comment on the results. And the reason I put that part in there is because something truly amazing happens when we perform this decomposition. All right, first we're going to show that e to the x is not even or odd. So what I do is test f of negative x, and I look for one of these two things to happen. Either it turns out to be f of x or negative f of x, or neither one of those things. So I get e to the negative x. Well, that's not the same as e to the x, so this function is not even. It's also not the same as negative e to the x, so the function is not odd. So we're done. And we've shown that e to the x is not even or odd. And if you think of the graph of e to the x, it doesn't have even symmetry or odd symmetry, so this is not a surprise. So let's get the even and odd parts of e to the x. E of x is going to be 1/2 times the original function f of x, that's e to the x, plus f of negative x. And this is a cool moment because I just realized that the hyperbolic cosine function is just the even part of e to the x. Now you might suspect what's going to happen next. The odd part of e to the x, according to the formula, I take e to the x, e to the negative x, subtract them. That's the hyperbolic sine function. Maybe to wrap things up here, we'll just look at the graphs of all of these functions. So we just figured out e to the x is cosh x plus sinh x, and cosh is the even part and sinh is the odd part. So how cool is this? We can start with a function that does not have even symmetry or odd symmetry. That's e to the x right there. And we can break it down into a function that has even symmetry, that's the cosh function, and a function that has odd symmetry, that's the sinh function. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.